Police are receiving a lot of criticism coming out of the Uvalde shooting of their unwillingness to go in and actually save people, as is their responsibility. Well, we've got another case, feels kind of similar, maybe even more callous. It involves cops who had been dispatched to a waterside domestic situation. When they get there, both members of the couple say that nothing had happened. But as they were investigating, apparently the man and the couple decided to try to flee and ends up swimming, and everything goes as horribly as you can possibly imagine. We're gonna show you, to the limited extent that we can, the body cam footage from that incident.
You're not allowed to swim in the lake. How far do you think he's gonna be able to swim?
Now that is as much of the footage as we can show you, because they are not making clear the rest of it. And we can speculate as to why. We have the transcript though, so I feel like when you hear what they were saying as this went on, you'll understand why. That was Sean Bickings who swam away, is in Tempe Lake Town, Arizona. He died, he drowned while swimming, despite the cops being nearby. And the reason is gonna become clear. Let's read some of the transcript. He said at one point, "I'm drowning." The officer says, "Come back over to the pylon." He says, "I can't, I can't." The officer says, "Okay, I'm not jumping in after you." Victim says, "I'm going to drown, I'm going to drown." The second officer says, "No, you're not." The man begs, "Please help me, please, please, please." Now, while this is going on, the wife is desperately trying to get them to help this man who's in the process of drowning. Says, "Stop, get off of me, he didn't do nothing wrong." The officer says, "We didn't say he did anything wrong." The officer apparently threatened to detain the wife, telling her, "If you don't calm down, I'm gonna put you in my car." And she says, "I'm just distraught because he's drowning right in front of you and you won't help." Officer notes that Sean hadn't resurfaced from the water for 30 seconds. Officer says, "You need to chill out." She says, I love him." They say, "Please stop being so aggressive."
Oh,
and he
God.
Drowned. Every bit of it was as explicit as is imaginable. He literally said, "I'm drowning." And they watched it happen. The most they could get worked up to do was to threaten the woman. And that's it. That is what they saw as fulfilling their obligation to protect and to serve Francesca.
I think the craziest part of this story has got to be the amount that they are trying to explain human emotion to police officers. "I'm drowning." That's where you lose breath in water and water starts to enter your lungs. "I am distraught because my husband is doing the drowning thing we just explained to you. Please help." Like, what? Because we all know, if you get, if you get upset, or if you show any more emotion than explaining emotion to police officers, you are immediately the enemy. And I guess they don't know how to read when someone is in distress. I guess they don't know how to read when someone is upset. It's just disgusting and awful. And you're like, I don't care how he ended up in the water, whether he was supposed to swim or not. The price for swimming when you're not supposed to swim in the river should not be your life. And they're right there. Imagine if this were bystanders, who would they have called? They would have probably tried to call the police. Would the police have helped in that point? Seems like they wouldn't have. And maybe would those bystanders have actually tried to jump in themselves? I mean, we saw in Uvalde how police officers prevented parents from trying to get into the school to help. And so once again, the ineptitude, the laziness, the callousness of so many officers on display right here.
Yeah. And you know, thankfully this got out, people are talking about it. That enters us into the only possibility that anything will be done in these sorts of cases. And as of right now, the officers have been placed on non-disciplinary paid administrative leave. So they're on vacation, I think is what that is. they're on vacation now for a while. You might be wondering, well, for how long? How long were you planning on paying attention to this story? That's how long. It could be a day, it could be 5 days, maybe it'll be 2 weeks. I'm betting it won't last that long, and then they will be back in duty. I mean, look, cops who actively choke the life out of people barely suffer any consequences. Those who from a distance willingly watch someone die and make the situation even more traumatic for the surviving family members of the person who died, they're not gonna suffer any consequences whatsoever. Like Francesca, for you or I, what they did, even if not intentional, let's say they didn't think he was gonna die, but they did what they did, they said what they said, and then the person drowned. This would haunt us for the rest of our lives. It would be the worst thing that we'd ever done, and it would be the only thing we could think about.
And if it were a child—
What do you think for them?
I mean, the other thing, I'm like, if this person were a child, that could be criminal, right? That could be criminal negligence for allowing a kid, your own child, to die. So there's just a lot of context here, which is again, even sort of more searing when you think about what happened at Uvalde. No, yeah, I mean, this would be awful, but this is just sort of another day for them. I mean, because he disobeyed. And honestly, a lot of police officers, maybe it's the training that apparently we're told they need more of, but I guess there's somewhere in the training that says, if you disobey orders, that person is okay to die and you no longer have to serve or protect them. The jurisdiction ends when you told them to do something, they didn't do it, and that, well, bets are off, bro. No, they're not there to save people's lives. They're there to police black and brown communities.
It's just horrifying.
That's why you call the fire department. Anybody knows that. Call the fire department.
Exactly. Literally, call a lifeguard next time. It would be more useful yes. to you than yes. a cop, because they would at least be brave enough to try to rescue someone. Like, I just think about the experience of the partner there. They're so helpless trying to convince these people who do not care to do their job. Like, you see the person is screaming that they're drowning. Everything was set up to produce what should have happened, which is saving this person. It was so explicit. Like, the DOJ announced that they're gonna have this new policy where if the FBI sees cops like brutalizing someone, they're supposed to intervene. Like, what are you supposed to do in this case? Like, you can't force them to do their job. And they're only like, I understand, Sophie, we're not gonna be doing another one this time. How do you reform this? Like, it just, I'm sure there's good cops or whatever. I know some people are saying there's good cops or whatever, but like, I don't know. It seems like a lot of bad apples. It really does. It seems like a lot of people who really feel no obligation whatsoever to actually help people. And to make these choices just in the wake of so much negative attention towards cops and to still choose this way.
Right. And it's funny, like, firefighters don't need to have like basketball tournaments with community, like, you know, centers in order to prove that they're like not horrible. They just don't have to do that kind of PR, because firefighters mm-hmm. truly save lives. So if police truly served and protected, and not just protected capital and protected wealthy communities, and weren't just sort of custodians again for like crap mayors, we might actually have a different view of them. They were actually heroes rather than just sort of like glorified bouncers for society. We might actually salute them. If they prove themselves to do anything, show me a good cop story, man. Send it on my way. It can't have been staged.
Exactly. No, we try. Like, we don't avoid that news. It's just, Jesus, the choices that are made. In any event, okay, we're running up against the end of the hour. I didn't want to, we have an important topic to talk about in the next one. I didn't want to try to cram it into like 3 minutes or whatever. It deserved more time. So we're going to give it more time on the other side of the break that is coming up, which means we have a minute or so to read some of your comments. Want to thank everyone who's been writing into us, including Jimbo Dragon, has been a member for 9 months over on YouTube, says, I mean, the cops might have drowned too. They can't just go in themselves. They might get hurt or killed if they do their job. We expect too much. Yeah.
What about you know, the sort of like really amazing tactical gear, water wings?
I don't know if that's a part of the standard kit.
Like, do they not have a life preserver? Doesn't it make sense to be like, I have a ring? Like, lifeguards only have rings. Do you feel like if you're like patrolling somewhere near water, maybe you have a ring on you?
If that's what you feel is necessary to be willing to do your job. Yeah. It's very frustrating. I will just say that. It's very frustrating. Anyway, don't take the job if you're not willing to do the job. That's the thing. It is more difficult and it is scarier than most jobs. It's much, much scarier than this job, which is why I'm doing this job instead of that job. You made the other choice. Thus, you are now bound by it. Sometimes I don't like talking about the news, but that's what I signed up for. So I gotta do it, okay?
I think you would be a pretty good, to be honest with you, police officer, because the moral, it's moral decision making that they don't test for. And I feel like yours would be pretty strong.
Well, I appreciate that. I have a feeling that if they were to watch some of the back videos of TDR, my time there would be rough.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.